Well friends, this is our English period and today we are going to learn one lesson, that is Coorg. Already we have started the lesson, The Glimpses of India. In that lesson, there are three parts. First part already we have learned, that is a baker from Goa. So in this lesson, exactly what we are going to learn, some part of India which are very attracted one. And we want to see the actual area of that. What are the features of that area that we are going to learn in this lesson. So in the baker of Goa, we have learned about that particular person, it was the pen portrait of the baker, and still it has a certain impact in the society in Goa. So that we have learned, which was quite related to Konkan. So now if you see that in the month of June, July, August, September, in Konkan also, many people come to see the scenery of our Konkan region, because it is great, divine, heavenly, natural scene we see in Konkan region. So Coorg, also near to Maharashtra, if you go to the Karnataka, in that particular western ghat of Karnataka, this particular Coorg district lies. It lies between the Mysore and Karnataka, okay, and it has great scenery. So that exactly we are going to learn in this lesson. This is not the story of a particular one of the character or something. It is the description of one place, one district, which has which has great impact on the tourist. So the writer of the lesson is Lokesh Abrol. So Lokesh Abrol, he is by profession he's a doctor, and most important thing in his character that he is a traveler. Okay, we also travel, but our traveling is only to reach one of the destination. But what he does, he travel and he write something about that particular place. So he likes to travel throughout India. He has traveled a lot and he has written many episode on some part of the tourist spot of our India. So we know that very well. Lokesh Abrol is a doctor by profession, but he is a traveler and he is a writer, and his writing work mostly include the description of the many tourist places. So what exactly we are going to learn in this lesson? That we are going to learn a place in the Karnataka and famous for coffee, rainforest and spices. So this is the lesson, which is not going to give us a story of one of the person, a story of one of the incident. No, it is going to give us a very interesting information about one district of Karnataka. Okay, we'll see that. So Coorg, actually this is not the common name of any village or any district for us, but as it belongs to Karnataka, so the name is Coorg. Okay, Coorg, Coorg is the name of the lesson. This is the district in Karnataka. Okay, we will see that lesson. So it's a midway between the Mysore and coastal town of the Mangalore, sites in a piece of heaven. So this place is depicted or referred as a place of heaven. Okay, so it's a great place we can see to visit. So on Sunday, now it is a very difficult situation, so we are at home. But when we go outside in the month of June, July, August, we see in Konkan region also a great greenery outside. We see that total our Mother Earth is decorated by the greenish leaves and all. Then we see somewhere waterfall, and we know that totally engrossed in the nature. We become so happy, we become so positive because of this scenery, because of this picturesque scenery of nature. So like that, Coorg also, it is lies between Mysore and Mangalore. In between it is there. It's a heavenly place, depicted from the kingdom of God. It is given nicely, described. It's like a kingdom of God. Means God, where God lives, that place is there, that place has come from heaven here in the form of Coorg. So that much effective, that much very, very beautiful place we can see in the Coorg. So the land of the rolling hills is inhabited by proud race of marital men. So this is very divine place. And who is living there? Marital men. And proud race. They have a proud race, means they belong to very very proud race. And beautiful women and with the wild creatures. So everything is there in that place. Everything is there. So one should go there to see. One should go to meet those people. Okay. That much this Coorg village is very, very beautiful. So Coorg or the Kodagu. The name of the Coorg is also Kodagu. The smallest district of the Karnataka. Is home of the evergreen rainforest, spices and the coffee plantation. So here we can find coffee plantation. You know, we drink coffee. So that coffee beans we get from that Coorg, because there are many coffee plantation as well. Evergreen rainforest cover 30% of this district. Evergreen means throughout the year there is a rain. That is why it becomes evergreen. So this is evergreen forest. So around 30% of the forest is evergreen forest in this region. During the monsoon, it pours enough to keep many visitors away. So in monsoon season, we can't go there because there is a heavily rain. We can find there heavily rain. So one cannot go there in the monsoon season. Means June to September, we can't go there because it is a evergreen. This is the region of evergreen forest. So we can understand the features of the evergreen forest. You might have learned in the geography. The season of the joy commences September and continues till March. So suppose you have to go there, you have to enjoy. If you want to enjoy there, then you have to go, you have to reach there in the month of September, and you can go till March, till you can enjoy the beauty, enjoy the atmosphere, enjoy the people in the Coorg from September to March. And continues till March. The weather is perfect. If you want to go there from September to March, the weather is perfect to enjoy. Because suppose we go somewhere and there is a great, hot or humidity, much more humidity, or only rain, or only chilly weather, then we can't enjoy the place. But in this Coorg village, Coorg district, you can go from September to March, you can enjoy the atmosphere also. You can't find that it's the inverse atmosphere. It is very pleasant atmosphere there if we go from September to March. The weather is perfect with some showers thrown in form of good measure. The air breathes of the invigorating is very giving us a very great energy. In grading coffee. Coffee estates and colonial bungalows stand tucked under tree canopy. Canopy means hanging cover in the prime corners. You can see some bungalows there in the prime corners as well. The fiercely independent people of Coorg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descendant. Now, when we think about the people of that region, then there are two opinions. That those people belongs to Greek or Arab. So why those people are belongs to Greek? That we can understand because before many years Alexander was there and he ruled there, right? And after that he could not go out. Then the people of the Greek had married with those locals, and that is why some people say that. The Coorg peoples are Greek descendant. Okay, you'll see that what exactly. A Greek or Arabic descendant. As one story goes, a part of the Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here, and when returned become impractical. These people married amongst the locals and their culture is apparent. We can see the culture of the Greek culture there in their behavior, in their daily routine. we can clearly see that happen, not clearly, in the marital tradition. Suppose we see the marriage ceremony of the Kur people, it is quite similar to Greek people. Also, marriage and the religious rites also quite similar to Greek, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. Even Karnataka is from, in India. So, in India, mostly Hindu people are living. But these, the rites and customs are there of those people are quite distinct, means they are different from Hindu people. So we can understand that they are belongs to, maybe they are belongs to Greek. The theory of the Arab origin draws support from the long black coat with an embroidered vest belt worn by the Kodavos, known as the Kufia. It resembles the Kufia owned by the Arabs and the Kurds. Okay, so another theory is given there. The costume which Kuk people wear, okay, the costume, their whatever they wear, so that particular costumes those people wear, that exactly resembles the Arab people, because it is, what exactly costume they wear? They have a long black coat with the embroidery at the waist level, and similar kind of the costume Arab people also wear, and they call it Kufia, and these Kurd people call it Kupia. Okay, so name are also quite similar. So people say, or some thinkers say that these people or Kuk people are belongs to Arab also, Arab descendants. So there are two ways, because of the Alexander army, we can say that some people say that those people are from Greek, or Greek descendant, and because of their costume, we can understand they are might be from Arab descendant. So this is what the origin of the Kuruk people. Now we will see Kurgis have a tradition of the hospitality. So you know that in hospitality, Atithi Devo Bhava, they have great that behavior with the Atithi, means guest. They have great tradition of the hospitality, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their sons and fathers. And when any people, when people comes to visit their village or visit their district, what they do? They they fond to tell the story of the their ancestor, their brave people, because they have certain army background. Many people have shown their bravery, so they never tired to tell stories of their forefathers or their brothers about their bravery. The Kuk regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian army, and the first chief of the Indian army, General Kariyappa, was a Kurgi. And if we see the history of the Indian army, we can understand the first general chief of Indian army was Kariyappa. General Kariyappa was the first Kurgi person who was a first Indian army chief. Okay, so even now Kodus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. So they have great permission from the Indian army. They can, people from the Kurg village, Kurg district can use these arm fires without a license. So that much efficient background they have. The river Kaveri, now we will see the surrounding area or wildlife, we will see from this of this Kurg village. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forest of Kurg. So we can understand that nearby there is a Kaveri river. You know that river Kaveri is a very great, and we know the name of the Kaveri river as well. So it is surroundings of the Kurg forest. And Mahashir, a large freshwater fish, abound in this water. We can see the Mahashir is one kind of fish we can find out in the Kaveri. A large kingfishers dive for their catch, then while squirrels and the langurs means monkey, drop partially eaten fruits from the mischief of the enjoying the flesh and the ripple effect in the clear water. And so we can find out there, so we have seen one of the fish, that is Mahashir, and then large fish, kingfisher also we can see in that particular area, in the Cook area. So squirrel also we can see, monkeys also we can see. Monkey eats the fruits and they put that some fruits in the water and they enjoy the ripples comes out. When we put something in the water, then we can get the circle, that is the ripples of the water we can see, and they enjoy it. Elephant enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahout. Mahout means the person who drives elephant. So elephant enjoys in that enjoy the bath in the that particular river. Okay, the most laid back individuals become convert to the life of high energy adventure with the river rafting. And suppose you will go there, what will fascinate you? That you will enjoy the sport, adventurous sport there. Okay, when we go to outing, when we go for the go at the tourist spot, what exactly we want? We want great natural scenery. We want pleasant atmosphere. And one more thing we want, that is cuisine. Okay, fine. Another one, that we need to enjoy with the sports. And suppose there is the mountain climbing is there. Okay, or rafting, river rafting is there. Or another is there. The rock climbing, canoeing is there, then one can enjoy a lot there. So similar kind of the scenario, similar kind of the adventurous sport we can find at the Coorg. The most laid back individuals become converts to the life of high energy adventure with the river rafting, canoeing, rappelling. Rappelling means what? Going down a cliff by sliding down a rope. That is the game. Then rock climbing. Rock climbing is a very difficult one, but one who does that will enjoy. Then it is given here mountain biking. So that aaj kuch tufani karte hain like that. So mountain biking is a very adventurous sport there. Numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with the trekkers. So for adventurous sports also we can go and visit the Coorg. Then wildlife, you'll see birds, bees and butterflies are there to give you company. Then macaws, then Malabar squirrels, langurs means monkey, and the slender lorries keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. And those birds and animals can be seen there, and they look at you from the canopy, from the high top of that particular trees. I do, however, prefer to step aside for the wild elephants. And you can see already we have got the information about the elephant from this lesson. The climb to the Brahmagiri hills brings you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Coorg. Panoramic, large extended area. When we go up, then we can see from the top the large expanded area, that is a panoramic view that we can see. And then a walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64. If you go walk across the rope bridge, there is rope bridge, and if you go across that, then we will see 64 acres lands of the Nisargadhama. Okay, 64 acres. So we can understand how much vast area, okay, of that. Running into the Buddhist monk from India's largest Tibetan settlement at nearby Bailakwipe is a bonus. And you know, it is so nearby that it's a India's largest Tibetan, I mean, Buddhist monk are living there. This is a great settlement of the Buddhist monk, which we can see there. The monks in red, then orchard and yellow robes are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right here in the Coorg. So many fascinated things are there if you go and if you visit to Coorg village or Coorg district of Karnataka. So one will not be unhappy or will not be unfortunate to go there. Suppose they will go there and will not say anything like which is negative about the place. One who will go there will enjoy, even though one very lazy person is there, and if he will go there, then too he will enjoy. He will find out the great energy in himself. Because the place is a heavenly place. It's okay. That is why in the first paragraph it is written that it's a kingdom of God. It's a place of God. It's a heavenly place, which is in the Karnataka. So what we have learned in this lesson? So Coorg, by location abroad, he is by profession he is a doctor, but he is a traveler, and he has traveled a lot throughout India, and he has depicted many very interesting information about the various tourist spot, and he has written that so that people can enjoy the outing or touring. Then we have seen that Coorg village lies in the Karnataka. It is between the Mysore and Mangalore. It is mainly it is known for the coffee, rainforest and spices. Then it is the smallest district of Karnataka. Then the best visit to that particular place in between September to March. The people living there are probably descended from Arabs and Greek. Why Greek? Because the Alexander army was there before many years, and it was very impractical to go out of the country. So what they did, they married the soldiers married with the local people, local women there, and that is why we can understand these are from the Greek belongs. Okay, they are originally from the Greeks. Also, we can find out if we see the Hindu marriage customs, and there is quite different. Even though they are living in India, but their customs and the rituals are Greek people. So we can come to know that it is from the Greek. They are from the Greek, or whatever the costume they wear, black costume they wear, and it is there are certain embroidery work at the waist level. So it is a kufiya. Okay, they use the name of their particular costume is kufiya, which is resemble to kufiya of the Arab people. So maybe they belong to Arab country also. So this is the opinion of the people, that they might be from the Arab or the Greek. Then culture, if we see the culture of those people, they are very great in hospitality. They like to tell many stories about their bravery, because we know that one of the first General Kariyappa is the first Indian army chief, and that is why they have got the permission to use firearms without a license. So that is why. And Coorg is one of the most decorated regiment in Indian Army. The speciality of the Coorg regiment is that is one of the most decorated regiment in Indian Army. Then we will see that variety of plants and birds made the place very picturesque, or we can say very heaven. We see that there are fish. Okay, then many fishes are there. Then kingfisher birds are there. Then we see squirrels. Then langurs, mean monkeys, are there, who just put some fruits in the water, and they enjoy the ripples of the water. Kaveri river surrounding that particular district, that is Coorg district. Then this place offers number of adventure sports also, because one can go there and one can enjoy the place by utilizing their time for the adventure sports. So we can find out the rafting, river rafting, then canoeing also, then rock climbing, rappelling also there. And when we go further, we will get there some panoramic way. Okay, that large vast area. Then there are certain Nisargadhama, which is around 64 acres land, and there is a great settlement of the Buddhist monk. So these are the things which make this place a beautiful one and attracted one. So this is the description of the one of the place of India which is like a heaven on the earth. So that is the pen portrait of this particular place that we have learned in this lesson. The lesson was Coorg, and I think you have understood the Coorg, and surely when you will complete your class 10th and you want to enjoy your vacation, you will go to that place and you will enjoy all these things which I have taught in this lesson. You will go and you will see the people, how the people are there, how you can witness their hospitality. You will listen some stories of their forefathers or brothers, how they have put their bravery in the army, Indian army. They have very proud history of Indian army. So that also you can enjoy. you can enjoy the hospitality, you can enjoy river rafting, many adventurous sports also. You can see the beautiful scenario, you can see wildlife creatures there, and you enjoy that Nisargadhama also. Okay, also you enjoy to see, or you see the most largest settlement of the Buddhist monk. So I hope that you have understood this lesson, and there is no worry if any question will come from this lesson from in your class 10 CBSE board exam. So you have to write the flowchart of the lesson, write down the features of the this particular place, and get ready for the exam. Okay, thank you very much.